I used 3DVOS, desktop filament extruder, and made my own 3D printing material in different colors at home to show you how the manufacturing process works, starting from plastic pellets, over different colorants and additives, all the way to the extrusion process. And I'll even take a sneak peek at recycling failed prints into new filament to print with. Let's find out more. Guten Tag, everybody. I'm Stefan. And welcome to CNC Kitchen. Part of this video is sponsored by Squarespace. Start a free trial today at squarespace.com/cnckitchen. Making filament for 3D printing is fundamentally not that hard. You take plastic pellets, mix them with some pigments, melt and feed them through a nozzle, and spool everything up. In this video, we'll take a look at the relatively simple process of extruding filament from virgin plastic pellets, but also quickly touch the challenges of recycling failed prints into a new spool of material, which will be the content of the next video of this series. If you don't want to miss that, make sure to be subscribed and select the notification bell. The raw material for most 3D printing filament comes in the form of these plastic pellets. In this case, it's PLA. So not all PLAs are equal. More precisely, this right here is NatureWorks 4043D PLA, a pretty common so-called material grade used to manufacture 3D printing filaments. Depending on your application, you can choose between a ton of various grades, differing in properties, in our case especially melt flow index, which is a measure of the viscosity of the melt. A low melt flow index means high viscosity and is what you want for extrusion, because the filament needs to keep its shape. A high melt flow index means a low viscosity and is, for example, used in injection molding, where the material needs to flow into every last bit of the mold easily. Let's first make the most simple type of filament, natural PLA, without any color or other additional additives besides what the manufacturer put in it. I weigh up a bunch of pellets and toss them into the hopper of the 3DVO Filament Composer 450 that 3DVO kindly lent me for a couple of months for my filament making and recycling experiments. Then I simply select the extrusion template and wait for the machine to heat up. Once the selected temperatures in the four heating zones are reached, the machine automatically starts extruding. That is pretty important because polymers degrade when they are exposed to high temperatures for longer periods of time and can potentially clog the extruder if the material is not constantly moved through it. Honestly, that's also what happened to my filler extruder and Mahor pellet extruder while experimenting with extruding shredded PET bottles because I wasn't aware of the severeness. After a couple of turns of the feeding screw, the material starts coming out of the nozzle. Very interestingly, this nozzle doesn't have the diameter of the filament you want to make, but with its 4mm diameter, is quite a bit bigger. The reason for that is that 3D printing filament is usually not directly extruded into shape, but a puller wheel is actually dragging the material to its final diameter that is adjusting the speed at which it's pulling depending on the diameter measured by an optical sensor. This way the machine can compensate for not perfectly equal extrusion and die swell. To make sure that the filament doesn't get squished from the puller and to make sure that it doesn't just droop down after it leaves the nozzle, it gets cooled by two cooling fans that blow on it. Since I had another material in the extruder before adding the PLA, I'm first purging that out, and during this waiting time, the temperatures within the whole machine stabilize to give us a more precise filament diameter in the end. Once PLA is coming out of the nozzle and the diameter stabilized, we can continue with spooling. You can spot when the material is coming out of the nozzle because the HDPE that was in the machine before crystallizes into white filament, whereas PLA remains mostly transparent. I put an empty roll on the holder for spooling, put it into the machine, and started the spooling wizard. I quickly snap off the filament, drag it through the positioning lug and a small hole on the spool, and then start the winding process. While the spool starts turning, I bend over the end of the filament so that the material doesn't come off the spool. And now we wait. The 3DVO Composer continuously adds new pellets through the hopper into the extruder, where the 3-zone compression screw first feeds it, then compresses and starts to melt it, and finally fully melts it and especially homogenizes it in the so-called metering zone before it leaves the nozzle. Just as an interesting side note, you might think that the material primarily melts due to the heaters around the barrel. But especially in the metering zone at the end, a significant amount of heat is internally generated just by the friction and the shear motion that the particles and also the melt does. Once all the pellets are consumed, I can turn off the spooling, cut the filament, and take my roll of material out of the machine. Not the perfect winding of the Prusa spools, but honestly, I've seen worse. And this process can actually be optimized by fine-tuning the settings, as we'll see in a bit. The color is really nice and clear, and it prints perfectly well. Transparent material is nice, but honestly, because the prints always turn out not perfectly clear, we rarely print with such a material. This is where color comes in. Coloring plastics is usually done with a so-called master batch. A master batch are pellets of highly concentrated pigments held together mostly by the same or a compatible polymer that you're processing. Just a more manageable and more controllable way than mixing powdered pigments with your pellets before the extrusion process. My friends from Das Filament, a German filament manufacturer from which I buy most of my PLA and PETG filament, were so kind to send me a bunch of samples to play around with. Since you're usually only adding 1-5% of the master batch to your normal pellets, I only needed a couple of grams that I'm sure the master batch manufacturers would not have been happy to sell me. Let's first start with red filament. For that, I add 2% of master batch to my PLA pellets, thoroughly mix it, and fill everything into the hopper. Of course, it again needs a couple of minutes until we get red material out of the nozzle, because we have to purge out the old material at first. After that, it's the same procedure as before, threading the end of the filament through the positioner and the spool, and start winding. Since there aren't many particles of master batch in the pellets, it's very important that the extruder screw builds up pressure and performs a lot of mixing and shearing motion in the metering zone to mix the melt properly and to get even colors. 3DVO provides, besides their extruder, monitoring software that you can use to track all the extrusion process parameters. In our case, when we only extrude simple PLA, the diameter is what concerns us. As we can see, the diameter fluctuates a little, mostly between plus minus 0.05 millimeters, sometimes a little more. I have already tried to tweak the process parameters even more, using different temperatures, fan settings, and screw speeds. But since I'm just starting using this machine, I'm okay with the results. Honestly, if you look at the size of the machine that is just using as much desk space as a Prusa Mark III, you can't expect the preciseness of an industrial extrusion line. And here we go, a bunch of red filament that again prints beautifully. Let's next get even a little fancier and add, besides the color master batch, also these sparkly pellets. I didn't know how much to put into the mix, so I used 2% blue master batch and 1% sparkle master batch. And into the hopper it goes. Again, we need to purge out the red filament that's still in the barrel. Still, this time the transition is actually lovely, because when the two colors start mixing, we get a really nice purple color that sparkles. Here, I'm purging everything out, but if you've ever bought rainbow filament, they actually stack different colors on top in the hopper and create these transitions on purpose. Looking at the melt before was interesting, though this time it's really mesmerizing to watch the molten PLA flowing out of the nozzle that then gets slowly drawn to the final diameter and wound up onto the spool. In the end, the filament got a little less sparkly than I hoped. Though still, the blue with a hint of stars is quite a nice material, and also prints gorgeously. Since I adjusted the spooling parameters, the winding also already looks quite a bit nicer. The part everyone probably was already waiting for is to extrude some failed 3D prints. And yes, I also have the shredded 3DVO's desktop plastic shredder, with which I have already ground up a bunch of failed 3D prints, dried the material and extruded it. Though it hasn't been perfect yet and was sometimes even rather bad. You have to understand that reusing failed prints is way harder than extruding virgin material. You need to make sure that you only have the same polymer. Clean it, shred it, sieve it, shred it, sieve it and dry it. Since you end up with quite a fluffy material, feeding that at a consistent rate into the extruder can be quite tricky. I have already extruded a bunch of regrinds that printed beautifully afterwards, but since this process is not yet perfect, we'll cover the whole detailed process in the next video. In the end, let's also address the elephant in the room, the price of the 3DVO filament extruder, because they only start at around 5,000 bucks. But before you scream, their machines are not targeted at makers and people that want to extrude their own PLA filament at home just because buying pellets is way cheaper than the final filament. Their machines are intended to be used in labs, where you want to try out new polymers, additives or extrusion ideas at a small scale before you go into full industrial production. For that, those machines are probably the most compact yet capable things that you can get. I honestly am very happy for this cooperation. Of course, it's not maker equipment, but due to my limited time, it gives me the possibility to try out things way quicker than I would be on, for example, the Filastruder. I think trying out things on this machine, rather than not at all, is still interesting for everyone. This might still inspire some of you to dedicate your time to replicate or experiment with more affordable solutions. So maybe a last thought. If you're thinking about 3D printing materials like PEEK and look at the filament prices, extruding these on your own machine might actually give you a return on investment pretty soon. Speaking of return on investment, it doesn't matter if you're a content creator, tinkerer, artist or a business owner. Squarespace, who sponsored this part of this video, is where you need to go if you're looking for a professionally looking website. Try out how easy it is to get started with a free trial at squarespace.com/cnckitchen. And when you later decide to launch your website, make sure to use code cnckitchen for 10% off and so that they know who sent you. Creating your own web presence is as easy as selecting one of their beautifully looking templates and then customizing that to your needs using your own content or even use their vast selection of stock photos. Squarespace lets you analyze the performance of your website using their powerful analytics tools, monetize your content by creating a members-only area to share exclusive content, or easily create your own store using their commerce tools. I created my website with dozens of articles around my videos using Squarespace and just love how easy it is to use and that all pages look just as nice on mobile as they do on desktop. Create your own website and support the channel at the same time by browsing squarespace.com/cnckitchen and use code cnckitchen for 10% off on your first website or domain purchase. So this was my first project using the 3DVO desktop filament extruder, which helped me to understand way more things concerning this process, and I hope you learned something as well. There is so much stuff I want to try out with it in the near future. Please let me know below if you have any questions and what you'd like me to extrude or recycle with this machine. Thanks for watching everyone. I hope you're doing all well. If you found this video helpful, then please leave a like, share it with the community and make sure that you're subscribed. If you want to support the channel, head over to Patreon, become a YouTube member or even check out my merch. Stay healthy, auf Wiedersehen and until next time. Little less sparkly.